My name is Dr. Roberto Palomares, an associate professor of pterygenology at the College of Veterinary Medicine, University of Georgia, and the coordinator of GRAVID, the Group for Reproduction in Animals, Vaccinology, and Infectious Disease. A common practice to prevent bovine respiratory disease is to vaccinate calves after weaning or after arrival to the new farm after long-distance transportations. These animals normally have a high level of stress, and also they have lower feed intake, which decreases the efficacy of this vaccination process. In addition, these calves commingle with cattle from other sources which have a different vaccination status and are exposed to pathogens that cause respiratory disease, such as bovine viral diarrhea virus, which is known for causing immunosuppression, which impairs even more the efficacy of vaccination. We perform a study to evaluate the onset of protection against BVDV2 challenge in newly received beef calf that receive a modified live virus vaccine and an injection with trace minerals Multimine 90. In this study, we use 45 Angus calf that had been weaned, and they were transported to the new location, and at arrival they were randomly assigned to three groups. The first group of 15 calves received a modified live virus vaccine containing respiratory viruses and an injection with trace minerals containing selenium, copper, zinc, and manganese Multimine 90. A second group received the same vaccine and a saline injection, and a third group of 15 calves did not receive vaccine. The animals were then challenged 5 days later with a BVDV2 strain 890, which is a moderate virulent strain, and the animals were evaluated during the next 18 days. Animals were checked daily for clinical scores, and blood and nasal swab samples were collected for laboratory analysis. BVDV infection resulted in higher clinical scores in calves that were not vaccinated. The calves that received injectable trace minerals concurrently with vaccination had significantly lower clinical scores compared to the unvaccinated calves. In addition, calves treated with injectable trace minerals had lower head ear scores. That means a better attitude from day 7 to day 11 after challenge compared to the other groups. The animals that were not vaccinated showed a significant leukopenia and lymphopenia, that is a reduction in the number of white blood cells, but the vaccinated calf maintained normal levels of white blood cells. The calf that received Multimine 90 had higher platelet counts than the other two groups. The calves that were treated with injectable trace minerals at the time of vaccination produced higher neutralizing antibody titers to bovine viral diarrhea virus 2 compared to the vaccinated calves receiving a saline injection and the unvaccinated calves. When we studied the leukocytes, specifically those that are very crucial for the immune response, the CD4 T helper cells and the CD8 cytotoxic T cells, the calf that received injectable trace minerals with vaccination and then were challenged with bovine viral diarrhea virus 2 had higher number of CD4 and CD8 T cells, mitigating the decay caused by the challenge with BVDV2. We performed another study in dairy calf that had been vaccinated with a modified live virus vaccine and received an injection with trace minerals or saline at the time of vaccination, and these animals were intranasally challenged with BVDV2 5 months after vaccination to test the long-term protection of this vaccination concurrent with injectable trace minerals. Even though the immune response after BVDV2 challenge was similar between the two vaccinated groups, the animals that received injectable trace minerals concurrently with vaccination had higher average daily gain compared with the unvaccinated groups. In conclusion, these two vaccination challenge studies demonstrated that the injection with trace minerals improved the serum and liver mineral status, also improved the health status after BVDV to challenge, and increased the antibody titers to bovine viral diarrhea virus 2. The injection with trace minerals helped mitigating the decay in CD4 and CD8 T cells caused by BVDV2 challenge and increased the platelet numbers. The animals that were treated with Multimine 90 had an improved attitude and higher average daily gain. The injection with trace minerals at the time of vaccination in dairy and beef calf improved the immune response and protection against BVDV2 challenge, which is associated with improvement in the health status and performance of these calves.
We run a registered Hereford and Angus operation here, and we calve around 500 calves total each year, about around 150 Angus calves and almost 300 Hereford calves. We market our bulls primarily through our bull sale, which is at the last Monday in February of each year. Also in the fall, we have a female sale. We first heard about Multimine by in a magazine article and reading some different trials. And when we saw the uses of Multimine, we thought it would be a good mineral to incorporate into our program, primarily because what is in Multimine is exactly what we are deficient in our area. We have a good oral mineral program in place here right now, but we feel that the use of Multimine, since we've started using that, has been able to increase our levels at the times of need and the times of stress. We feel that it's a program that works well in unison with an oral program. Prior to the use of Multimine, we saw a lot of Angus calves that had the red tinge to their coat, and since we've been using Multimine at birth on all of our newborn calves, we have seen none of that conditioning. We use Multimine on our baby calves when they're born, and we feel that it's an important piece of the puzzle in terms of our protocol to get the calves on into the branding season. We feel that the use of Multimine when they're babies helps increase our immunity and treat less calves through the springtime and through the kind of the harsher conditions of winter months. And once we get on into branding, we feel that because we have used Multimine when they're young, that it makes our vaccination program work stronger. We feel that the use of Multimine has prepared the cattle more for a stressful situation that they might occur, whether it be environmental changes or by going through an auction or a sale or stressing the cattle in terms of transportation or whatever it might be. We feel that because of the use of Multimine, that it has prepared those cattle to meet those challenges that they might face.